a brother, okay, recently called me, and he said there is a sister, she's asking him deep questions about Islam. Yeah, really, I don't want to mention them, really deep questions. And he said, I told her that I will ask a sheikh and I'll get back to you. Yeah, so I said to him, ya Habibi, you don't need, please listen, brothers, many of you are doing good things through social media. You want to do da'wah, you want to do khair, inshallah, that is good. But brothers and sisters, you are, please, 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 listen to this. You are still young. You have not taken from the experience of this terrible life. Yeah? Don't put yourself, wallahi, young brothers and young sisters, you might put yourself into troubles. Wallahi, you will regret it for the rest of your life. Yeah? The interaction between boys and girls. Subhanallah, it's the qadar of Allah. 2 days ago, yeah, two young boys came to me, very beautiful young boys. Yeah, 16, like my children, 16. I helped a brother, one of them, okay? And so he became a little bit, you know, he listens to me and takes my advice. I helped him. He had a problem, private issue. So I helped him. So the next day, or yeah, after some time, he brought his friend, okay? He is 16, yeah? 2 days ago, 2 days ago. And that young boy, he said, Sheikh, okay, private question, yes. He said, Sheikh, when I was 14 plus, I started to develop a positive feeling to one of the girls in my class. Yeah? So we started to go after the school. He said, every day we spent 2 hours together, either in the park or somewhere in the alleyway. When we were what? 14. Yeah? And then after that, Sheikh, he said, I did yani all types of haram things with her, except the full relationship. And he mentioned certain words that I was surprised that a boy, okay, at the 16 age, he knows about these things. So he said, I want to come out of haram. I went to my parents. I want to get married to her. Yeah? We spoke, the parents spoke, and we agreed. Yeah? I said to him, he said, but then the parents said, until you reach the age of 18. After the age of 18, you can get married. What do you think, Sheikh? It's very difficult to be away from her, Sheikh. I tried a number of times. Yeah? It is so difficult. I cannot stay away from her even for 3 days. Yeah? Immediately I ring her or she rings me. I go and see her. And we need a solution, Sheikh. I said, see. Okay, but my point is, I said to him, you might marry her at this age, yeah? But if you had, let me be honest with you, brothers and sisters, from experience, from what I have seen, if you start your sexual life at a very young age, don't tell me the Prophet ﷺ and Aisha and the Sahaba, they have done this in the past. Yes, in the past, because they have the social support. But if you have your journey, sexual journey at a young age, that will not be very helpful for you at a later stage. Yeah? You might get divorced at a young age. And then after that, you can't be away from sexual relationship. So you will do it either in a halal way or in a haram way with another person. So now you have tasted more than one person. You cannot be satisfied with one person. Later on, you will become older and you will be hungry for a sexual relationship. Yes, and that will put you in more troubles, okay, and troubles. That's why, brothers, young, many of you are like my children. We want to protect you. We want to protect you. Be away, okay, of those things. Otherwise, there are mistakes that might lead you to regret for the rest of your life. I'm spending two more days with you, any of one, and the mashayikh are here. Sheikh is here with you all the time. The brothers are here. If you have a problem, please, okay, approach any of us. We might try to provide you with a help that might really protect you against major problems you could put yourself in.
Stop! 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 I have a serious warning about the Muslims in Norway. Our youth have lost touch with their deen
And this means that the majority of them don't pray Salah, even though their parents do.
But here's the scary part. Once these kids get older without praying, and they get married and have children themselves, their kids aren't even going to know about Salah. And this is going to become the reality for a large portion of the Muslims in Norway.
We are working hard to solve this problem. Alhamdulillah, we've held over 30 conferences with thousands of people attending. We've flown in scholars from around the world and tried our best to re-establish their connection with Allah. But unfortunately, these conferences are not enough to make changes in the masses of our youth.
What we really need is a permanent Norwegian Muslim youth center, a masjid where the youth can transform their lives and become true worshippers of Allah. And we already have half the amount, but we need your help to reach the remaining 50%.
You can inshallah share in the reward of all those youth learning how to praise Allah. And when they grow up and have children who also start praying, you will share in their reward too.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the two rak'ahs before Fajr are better than this world and what's inside it. Then subhanallah, one person praying two rak'ahs before Fajr is better than the entire world and everything it contains. Can you then imagine getting the reward of hundreds of people praying Fajr every single day? All of this because of the Islamic Center that you helped establish.
So please, for the sake of Allah, help us establish this masjid and get your continuous reward and a palace in Jannah, inshallah. Click the button and donate now. And please, don't forget to share this video to get extra reward. Jazakallahu khairan.